Coming up, part four in our series, we'll show you everything that you need to know for deploying Office using System Center Configuration Manager. Now, I'm going to walk you through all the steps to create and configure an Office package, your options to define the experience for users, and the tools you'll want to know about along the way. All current versions of Office use the same click-to-run packaging type and are installed and configured in the same ways. And this is also true for Office 2019 and volume licensing editions like Professional Plus and Standard. Now, at the foundation, these click-to-run packages use an XML file to govern install time settings and configurations, and a setup.exe bootstrapper to run the installation. Now, to create the XML, you use the recently released Office customization tool, and you can find that at config.office.com. And this is also integrated with Configuration Manager 1806 and newer releases. Now, the setup.exe that you're going to use is called the Office Deployment Tool, and you can download that from Microsoft, and it's also integrated with Configuration Manager 1806 and newer. So if you're installing Office on a handful of PCs, you can do that manually, and you can use the Office Deployment Tool and Office Customization Tool to deploy using the scripted installation. So we know that most larger organizations are going to be using SCCM, and the good news here is the process I just described is fully contained in the Configuration Manager console, and the XML and setup.exe are already there too, so you don't need to go and grab those pieces. SCCM will download the Office installation files directly from the Office CDN as part of package creation. So now I'm going to walk you through all the steps in the process to build an Office 365 Pro Plus package in Configuration Manager. And this process is also used for Office 2019, Visio, and Project apps. Note that you can also use the standard app creation process, but it will require you to manually author XML files, download updated versions of the Office deployment tool, and the Office installation binaries themselves. Because of that, we actually recommend that you use the steps I'm going to show you now. So to get started, you can access the Office 365 Client Management Console. And here, if we go into Office 365 Installer, that's going to start the package creation process. Now, again, this works for Office 2019 Project and Visio as well. So here, I'm going to give it a name, Office 365 Pro Plus X64, because that's the package we'll be creating. And then I'm going to have to paste in a location of a blank folder location. And once I've done that, I can go ahead and click Next. Now I can open the Office Customization Tool. That's integrated from the Office Customization Tool's online version right here in Configuration Manager. Here I can select the architecture of Office I want to deploy, 64 or 32-bit. I can also select the Office products I'd like to deploy. So here you can see the Office 365 versions as well as Professional Plus and Standard 2019 volume licensing as well. You also see all the Visio and Project versions that you can deploy, and additional things like language packs and the access runtime. Now in the update channel fields, we're going to select the actual software update channels that we want to use. So here we can select semi-annual channel for twice per year updates, the monthly channel, which means feature updates will happen every month, and we also have targeted releases for both if you want to preview those builds. Now in the version selection, I can select the actual version for the monthly channel I want to deploy, and I'm going to go ahead and stick with the newest one. And here inside my apps configuration, I'm going to select the apps that I want to exclude from deployment. So I'm going to exclude Skype for Business, OneDrive, Groove Client, OneNote, Publisher, and I'll also exclude Access in this case because I don't want those installed on my client machines. Now in this case, I'm going to select the languages that I want. In my case, I'm going to do a primary English US language, and I'm going to select then a secondary language, and there are several options here. In my case, I want my secondary language to be simplified Chinese, so I'll go ahead and select that, and now I'll click Add. And I can add more languages if I want to, as well as proofing tools as part of this process. Now within the installation options, I can select, for example, here to log remotely my installation logs somewhere else. And here in the update options, I can remove previous versions of Office, but keep the apps that I want to keep, like Visio and Project. Now inside of the licensing and activation section, we can automatically accept the end user licensing agreement, and we'll see that listed out here. And also, if I've got a remote desktop services environment, I can select shared computer activation. Now within general, I'm going to give my company name there, and that's going to basically tag any document created by users once they've got Office installed. And in this case, I want to use the Office Customizations Tools policy preferences to block macros. So to do that, you go ahead and search for what you want to set. Here I'm going to search for macro, and I'm going to configure that macros are blocked, in my case, for Access or any other apps on my machines that I'm deploying to. And now once that's all configured and ready to go, I can click Finish. And then I can review all of my settings that I've just set through the Office customization tool as part of System Center Configuration Manager. So here are all the settings that we just went through listed out here. And now once I feel good about this, I can go ahead and click Submit. And then what that's going to do is actually take me to whether or not I want to deploy this package right now. So I can select Yes, and that will let me select a collection. But I'll keep the default here and keep No selected. And now when I go to the summary and click Next, it will actually go and download all the pieces that we need, the Office installation binaries, the Office deployment tool, that setup.exe bootstrapper I talked about earlier, and everything else as part of the deployment package. Now again, to go back to the point of the removal of previous installs of Office, we've done a lot of work there to make sure you don't have to run any pre-flight or pre-installation scripts like offscrub.vbs or other things you may have been doing. Now the installation and uninstallation of previous versions works seamlessly. Also, things like migrating architecture are possible through XML settings. So you can use the migrate arc as part of the uninstall and then reinstall the newer version so you can go from 32 to 64-bit with one installation. So now as this starts to download all the package files, what I can do is navigate to the same folder and directory that we saw earlier. It's still on my clipboard. So I'm going to go ahead and paste in the same location. And here we'll see all the stuff that's already been downloaded. And if I go into the Office directory, you can see that my installation binaries are also starting to download and they'll be ready in just a sec. So now the download's complete. I can see exactly where it's been stored to and I can click close. And now I'm ready to start deploying that out to the collections that I want to deploy to or as part of my operating system deployments that I'm doing. Now, the Office 365 Client Management Dashboard, SCCM, is also there to help you monitor the progress of your Office deployments. You can see here we've got quite a few different Office 365 client versions out, and we can see whether or not those PCs are managed or unmanaged. So a lot of great data here as well. So in the next episode, we're actually going to go deep into Office servicing and some proper troubleshooting and issue management using log files, registry settings, and also Office licensing scripts. Now you should be ready to upgrade your Office 365 installs with Office 365 Pro Plus using System Center Configuration Manager. You can find out more information at aka.ms/office-upgrades. Now stick around for part 5 in the series where we dig into updates for Office 365 Pro Plus management. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.